today. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Wa sallallahu wa sallam wa barak ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. As I mentioned before, we, inshallah, will continue till the month of Ramadan, which maybe we have 3 more meetings, and then we'll stop in Ramadan as we do always every year. I hope by this time we can reach the point which we finish at least about Salah, inshallah. Last week we started talking about Salat al Jumu'ah, Friday prayer, and I hope inshallah today that we can finish this inshallah. Let me just check something here and to make sure. I want to check this. طيب. So let's start as we do always to read the hadith, and then inshallah we'll explain it. Today we will move to the hadith of Ammar ibn Yasir radiallahu anhu, who said that he narrated that I heard the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, prolonging the prayer and shortening one's khutbah is a sign of one's comprehension of his religion. The hadith in Arabic, إِنَّ طُولَ صَلَاةِ الرَّجُلُ وَقِصَرِ خُطْبَتِهِ مِئِنَّةِ مِنْ فَقْهِهِ. Now what's the meaning of this hadith? This hadith and the other hadith, and in fact they are related. The next hadith is, which was also narrated by Umm Hisham bint Haritha, who said that I learned Surat Qaf, Surat Qaf, I know, you know, this is Surah in the Quran, by the glorious Quran, which is Surah number 50, I think, from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, for he recited open the pulpit every Friday when he addressed the people in Friday khutbah, and this was related by Imam Muslim. Both hadiths were reported by Imam Muslim. Let's go now to first of all to get the general meaning of these hadith, and then inshallah we'll continue to get some of the benefits that we learned from this hadith. Prolonging the salah, shortening the khutbah. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam given advice regarding learning how the imam, okay, how the imam should do. I mean, when he leads the salah in Friday, because as you see, there are some people when they get in the minbar, they will take long time. They will give long khutbah. Maybe he will speak for half an hour, for maybe an hour, maybe less. And then when he go to the salah, he will make it very short. The Prophet alayhi salatu wassalam here, you know, tell us some of the important point, which is the best thing for khutbah is what? To be short. And this is why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam praised the one who gives short khutbah and longer salah. Why? Because when he said مِئِنَّةَ مِنْ فَقِهِ, this is a sign that this person, alaykum as-salam wa rahmatullah, this person who makes his khutbah is short, that's show that he is a very wise person and he understands the objectives and also understand the purposes of this khutbah. Because this khutbah is not to give very long lesson. It's just to give certain advice, to emphasize certain points. And whenever the khutbah or the reminder is short, this will be more beneficial for people. Because people, they can comprehend it, they can remember what the Imam said. But if the Imam stay in the minbar, speaking for 30 minutes, half an hour, and people at the beginning, maybe they will concentrate. And it's proven, even in psychology, you know, that people always, they will have a very strong attention. They will comprehend almost everything in the first 5 or 10 minutes. They can concentrate. This is people always, if they attend speech, so at the beginning they are, you know, they are fresh. At the beginning they are highly motivated. So they may concentrate and they understand and they get what the points that the Imam want to teach them. After 10 minutes, or after this time, maybe 7 or 10 minutes, people start to get bored. Even the subject is interested, you know. So they maybe get bored. Maybe they come to think or remember something, you know, and they maybe, imagine different things, different troubles, different problems, think about different issues. So they will lose concentration in what the Imam say. So this person is, or the Imam is giving long hadith, long speech, while people already get, you know, bored and get tired. This is why always, if you want to benefit people and you want to give advice, you give reminder, you give khutbah, therefore it should be very concentrated. In few words, few statements, short speech, and people will remember it. They will not forget it. But when you talk a lot, then people, they get lost. They don't know which one, they remember, and what is, which thing they, they will lose or they forget. So people, they will not benefit from this. But it's very important to understand when we said that the khutbah is very short, that doesn't mean, to shorten it to the point that doesn't give the objective or the purpose of the khutbah. So he just give few words and he think that that's because I want to follow the sunnah and will make my khutbah very short. This is not the purpose by itself. The khutbah should be short, but also what? Should be complete. Should be complete and perfected in a way that, you know, the listener will get the message of the speech, the message of the khutbah. Okay? So here, that means he receive, he understand, he learn. So this is the purpose, not to make it short, just give two words and stop. So it is short, but at the same time, it is it's beneficial and it's covered the purpose of the speech by itself. This is why the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam sometimes give khutbah of Quran, like what it's mentioned in the second hadith. The Prophet alayhi wasallam sometimes, and it seemed that he do this frequently, because this sahabiyya, this lady who narrated this hadith, she said, I memorize Surat Qaf, this surah, because of listening. I learned it from the Prophet ﷺ, because he used to say it on Friday. So it will, that doesn't mean that he said it only once, but it seems that he repeated many times. So this lady and others, they memorized the surah, and which is surah is not that very short. So what is the standard to say this khutbah is short or long? Here the standard, the measure, like Surat Qaf. So Surat Qaf, less than this, a little bit more, this will be considered as acceptable, which we say maybe around 7 to 10 minutes, mostly, not more than this. طيب. But not what some people, as we said, you know, they make it very long. طيب. Now, why the Prophet ﷺ described this person who make the khutbah is short and the salah is longer? That this is so that he have real understanding, deep understanding of the religion, fiqh fi al-deen. Because salah is very important matter for every Muslim. Salah is the connection between the abd, between Allah Azza wa Jal and his servant. Therefore, the Muslim, any Muslim, he will find rest in the salah. So it doesn't matter if the salah, you know, it's getting lit longer, and the Imam reciting some verses of reminder, so he will benefit from this. And the Sheikh mentioned here the meaning of this salah. As you know, the Imam will recite Surat Al-Fatiha as we do in every salah. And there is hadith, which is hadith Qudsi that Allah Azza wa Jal said. It was reported by the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. Allah Azza wa Jal said, "Qasamtu salat baini wa bain abdi." That means I divided the salah between me and my servant or my slave. So when the one who's praying, he says, "Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen," Allah will say, "Hamidani abdi." My servant praised me. When you say Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, Allah Azza wa Jal will say, "Athna alayya abdi." Also, he praised me and he thanks me. Maliki yawm al-deen, Allah said, "Majjadani abdi." When he said, "Iyaka na'budu wa iyaka nasta'een," you alone we worship and you alone we get his help. This is between you and Allah. Because when you say, you are the one that we worship, this is for Allah, this is to worship. وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ, and we ask you to help us, this is for you. So this is the middle. This is why this hadith, you know, it was taken by some ulama, that the verses of Surah Al-Fatiha is 7 verses. Because some they say that they include Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. But here it is 7 without Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. قال ف when the, you know, the seven say اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين, Allah said, this is for my servant, this is what he asked and I will give it to him. So this is the connection between Allah عز وجل and his servant. This is why the Muslim, the believer, he always love to do salah, to recite this surah, because he is connection and communicating with Allah Subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the Muslim or the Imam who make the khutbah short, because the purpose of the khutbah is to give advice or to teach something or of the rulings. But the salah is, this is the purpose of the meeting in Yom Al-Jum'ah. طيب. And this is why the Sheikh said, what is the standard that we should follow? Because some people they said, 15 minutes, it's not long. Some people they say maybe even 30 minutes is not long. So here we are not looking for what people think, but we see what is the way of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So the Prophet alayhi salam in Salatu al Jumu'ah, he always recite 2 surah, which is like Surah Al-Jumu'ah and Surah Al-Munafiqun. These 2 surah, if you look at the Mus'haf, it will take 1.5 pages. Surah Al-Jumu'ah, 1.5 pages. Surah Al-Munafiqun also, 1.5 pages. The total is only 3 pages. Or in other time, he will recite Surah Al-A'la, سَبِّحْ اسْمَ رَبِّكَ الْأَعْلَى, and in the second rak'ah will recite Surah Al-Ghashiyah, هَلْ أَتَاكَ حَدِيثٌ غَاشِيَةٌ. So these are the common suwar or chapters that the Messenger of Allah used to read in Salat Al-Jumu'ah. That doesn't mean he only limited to this, but this is the common, this is the most thing. And if you look at these surah, especially Surah Al-A'la Wal-Ghashiyah, it was full of reminder. Reminder of the deed and the reward of the deed and the result of the person dead. If it's good, he will be rewarded. If it's not, he will be punished. So always remind about this. Now, Hadith Umm Hisham, which Ibn Haritha, when she said that, I learned Surat Qaf from the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, because he used to read it. And this, maybe some people they ask, SubhanAllah is interested, that just last week, last Friday, our Imam, when he pray, he only read Surat Al-Qaf at the member. First of all, because the best, as I mentioned last week, the best mention or reminder for the people, especially Muslim, is the Quran. The Quran is the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Very perfect, very truthful, very wise. It is the speech of our Creator. Therefore, it's full of every wisdom, knowledge, and when you, any of us, go to the Mus'haf and read this surah, Surat Qaf, which the Prophet ﷺ used to read it on Friday, because it's full of reminder. This is this surah was ended at the end, because it is Qaf, wal Qur'an al-Majid, starting talking about the Qur'an, and then talking about the people, and their standing of the Qur'an, and, you know, about life, about the signs of Allah in this universe, about the two ways, one to paradise and the other to the hell. Subhanallah, reminder. And at the end, what Allah Azza wa Jalla said, إِنَّ فِي ذَٰلِكَ لَذِكْرَى لِمَنْ كَانَ لَهُ قَلْبٌ أَوْ أَلْقَى السَّمْعُ وَهُوَ شَهِيدٌ. Truly, verily, in what was mentioned of these verses of Surah Qaf, لَذِكْرَى. These are reminder for whom? لِمَنْ كَانَ لَهُ قَلْبٌ. The one who listened carefully with his heart. أَوْ أَلْقَى السَّمْعُ وَهُوَ شَهِيدٌ. And he listened, but when he listened, he's not just giving his ear, but he's giving his ear and attention. So shaheed, that means he's a present when he listened to this word. Surat Qaf talk about the creation of man, from the beginning till the end. Surat Qaf talk about the Quran, because this is why it started by Qaf. وَالْقُرْآنِ الْمَجِيدِ. Talk about the Quran. So it is very great surah. This is why, my dear brothers and sisters, I advise you, inshallah, to get any nearest time to go and read this surah and go back to the tafsir. Go back to the comment of the scholar. And for sure you will find, subhanallah, a lot of reminder in this surah. طيب, if a person or khatib now giving khutbah in any place, people they don't understand Arabic, is it enough to just recite Surat Qaf? Maybe they will not understand it. Not only in Arabs, even Arabs these days, even Arabs. If a person, he stand in the minbar and only recite Surat Qaf. You see, the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, when he was reciting Surat Qaf, for them, they comprehend every word and every sentence, every verse, because the language at that time, their language is the language of the Quran. So, Allah Azza wa Jalla spoke to them the way they understand. But nowadays, even Arabs, they don't, you know, have the deep knowledge of the deep meaning of many of the original Arabic words. what they call it classic Arabic. So this language, which is very, you know, high and deep, it's need a person to understand. Therefore, it is advisable that even the Imam these days, he recites Surat Qaf, it's okay to make some comments, to explain some of the verses, not just reciting the Surah. And he said, well, this is what the Prophet ﷺ did. Yes, the Messenger of Allah ﷺ, when he recited to people, they understand. But nowadays, when you recite it, alaykum as-salam wa rahmatullah, when you are recited, you know, not everyone, you know, will understand every verse of this. From this also, hadith, some scholar, they said, this to show that on Friday, in the khutbah Friday, there should be some of the Quran. That means the khatib or the imam, when he give khutbah, he should. This is some of the scholar they are saying. And this is maybe, as the Sheikh said, it is a good point. Because the purpose of khutbah is to give advice. And the best of all advice, search for advice and teaching, is the Quran. Naam. So the ulama said, at least recite only even one ayah. One ayah. And this is why maybe you notice that all the khutbah now, when they start their khutbah, they start by reminding about taqwa, and they recite this ayah. When Allah, you know, maybe you hear this common in every khutbah. يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ اتَّقُوا رَبَّكُمْ الَّذِي خَلَقَكُمْ مِنْ نَفْسٍ وَاحِدَةٍ وَخَلَقَ مِنْهَا زَوْجَهَا till the end of the verse. So that's to come with this requirement, which is giving ayah. But what ayah? Any ayah? It should be ayah, complete ayah, so people, they get some benefit from it. Because there are some ayat in the Quran which is connected to other verses. If you didn't mention these verses together, it doesn't have, you know, it doesn't give the meaning. Like when they said, Mudhammatan. Mudhammatan. One word, which is in Surah Ar-Rahman. That doesn't give a meaning, you know, by itself. Why? Because this word is description for two paradise, two jannatan. So the word by itself, the verse by itself is not enough. So the point is to give meaningful verse by itself, or more than one verse, to complete the meaning so the person will learn. طيب. Let's go now back, I mean go to summarize some of the benefits that we learned from this hadith. First of all, this is an evidence about the importance. Welcome, Sister Iman, that's watching. So, there is evidence that the Quran is the more an important and valuable way that the Muslim or the Khatib or the advisor use when he advise other. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned about the Quran, when he said, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ قَدْ جَاءَتْكُمْ مَوْعِظَةٌ مِّنْ رَبِّكُمْ وَشِفَاءٌ لِمَا فِي الصُّدُورِ وَهُدًا وَرَحْمَةً لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ. This ayah said, All mankind, قَدْ جَاءَتْكُمْ مَوْعِظَةٌ. Really, verily, a reminders that's come to you from your Lord, مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ وَشِفَاءٌ لِمَا فِي الصُّدُورِ. And cure and healing for whatever in the heart. Alaykum as-salam wa rahmatullah. Wahudan, guidance. Wa rahmatan, mercy. But for whom? Guidance and mercy for whom? Lil mu'mineen. For those who believe. Because the Quran is cure, healing, guidance for the one who believe in it. But the person doesn't believe that this is the word of Allah. How can he benefit from it? So this is the point here. Now, second, as we mentioned here, that we conclude that in Khutbah al-Jum'ah should be there some of the Quran or some verses of the Quran. Also, we learned that the importance of Surat Qaf, which is Surah, great Surah that every Muslim strive to read it and to understand, because it's give the full story of man and the purpose of his creation from the beginning till he die, till he go to his final destination, either to Jannah, paradise, or may Allah protect us to the hell. طيب, the next hadith, which was narrated by Ibn Abbas رضي الله عنهما, he said, Ibn Abbas رضي الله عنه, he said, the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, listen to this carefully, whoever speaks in the Jum'ah while the Imam is delivering the khutbah is like a donkey who is carrying books. And for he who tells him to be quiet, there will be no reward of his Jum'ah. This hadith, by the way, some ulama, they said it is ضعيف. And Ahmad said it's acceptable chain narrators. And inshallah, we'll talk about this hadith after we go to the next one. إذا قلت لصاحبك أنصت يوم الجمعة والإمام يخطب فقد لغوت. This Abu Huraira narrated that if you look at this, if you during the Jum'ah prayer while the Imam is delivering the khutbah, you tell your companion, you tell the person beside you or somebody with you, be quiet. He start to talk and you want to give him advice to stop him from speaking. And to say to him, don't speak, stop speaking. You have spoken needlessly. So what should I do? I'm coming to this, inshallah. طيب, let's now explain these two hadith. نعم. This is related to the hadith. Yes. Al-Hafidh ibn Hajar, as you know, ibn Hajar is the one who wrote this or collected these hadith of Bulugh AlMaraam. So he brought them and reported these two hadith in the book of Jum'ah or the chapter of Jum'ah. And this related to what is the stand of the person when he goes to the masjid and the Imam is giving the khutbah. And also we learn from this hadith, what is the ruling of speaking or talking while the Imam is giving khutbah. First of all, we should understand that listening to the Imam while he's giving the khutbah is must. Because the khutbah is must for Friday. Therefore, listening is must. And this is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded us to go and attend Jum'ah. When he said, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu idha nudiya lis-salati min yawm al-jum'ah fas'aw ila dhikrillah. When it's time for Salatu al Jumu'ah, then you should go to the Salah. Just to show you that it is must to attend the Salah and listen to the Khutbah and leave all other transaction or business. This is why I said, فَسْعَوْ إِلَى ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ. Then haste, go. ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ, ذِكْرِ, remembering Allah. So this salah is ذِكْر. And people, they are leaving their business, their work, which is very important in their life, for what? Just to show you the importance of attending Jum'ah and listening to the two khutbah of the Jum'ah. طيب. The Prophet ﷺ said here, the one who speaks while the Imam Giving khutbah is like the example of a donkey carrying books. Now, what's this example? That means this person will not benefit from the khutbah because he's speaking. Same like if you have a donkey and you put books on the back of the donkey. Then this donkey, because, you know, this is the, you know, they give the example of the donkey in Arabic culture as the stupidest animal. He will not benefit from the book which is in its back. The same, this is the example of the person who will never, you know, benefit from what he was giving of knowledge. This is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described the Jew like this. مثل الذين حملوا التوراة ثم لم يحملوها كمثل الحمار يحمل أسفارا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala condemned some of the Jew, you know, and said, those who were giving the scripture, the Torah, and they didn't work accordingly, they didn't benefit from the Torah, the scripture that was delivered to them. كمثل الحمار يحمل أسفار. It's like a donkey that carrying books. So the donkey will never ever read and benefit from this book. So this is the example. If you notice that always in the hadith or the Quran, whenever it's giving the example of an animal for a person, this to show you that this person who Allah Azza wa Jal gives him the mind and the intelligent, when he doesn't benefit from this mind, from this knowledge that's come to him, it's exactly like an animal, because the animal will never learn or benefit from any knowledge it will be given to him. We're not talking about the training. And this always, whenever there's the Quran or the Sunnah will condemn something, it made example, give example of an animal. Like, for example, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala condemn those who raise their voice. You see in Surat Luqman, this is Surat Luqman. What Allah said, in أَنْكَرَ الأصوات لَصَوْتُ الحمير. The most ugly, you see, or noisy voice is the voice of the donkey when, you know, shout. That means don't speak loudly. وَغَضُضْ مِنْ صَوْتِكْ وَغَضُضْ مِنْ صَوْتِكْ. Therefore, when you speak, don't shout. Speak softly in a way that people, you know, intelligent people, they can hear you. But shouting more than it is needed, you know, it's like, you know. Also, Allah Azza wa Jal give the example of the person that Allah gave him wisdom, taught him, but he didn't benefit. وَاتْلُ عَلَيْهِمْ نَبَأَ الَّذِي آتَيْنَاهُ آيَاتِنَا فَانْسَلَخَ مِنْهَا. Tell them about the example of a person, the one that we gave him our verse, we gave him our sign, we showed him our sign, we gave him wisdom. But he didn't take it. He didn't benefit from them. فَأَتْبَعُوا الشَّيْطَانِ. So, the, you know, he's full of the shaitan. And then Allah said, so he is like a dog. He is like, this example, like the example of the dog. If إِنْ حَمَلْتَ عَلَيْهِ يَلَسْ أَوْ تَرَكْتُ يَلَهَا. If you, you know, as all we see, all the dog always have very quick breathing in all situation. If you kick him away or if you lift him, the same way. So this is the person, you know, Allah Azza wa Jalla give the example of such people. They don't. Also in the Sunnah of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam also give some example of this. So the point is, that when you come to the khutbah, then you should benefit from whatever the imam is giving and delivering, and not be like a donkey that if he carry books, he will not benefit from the books. Therefore, it is very important to pay full attention to the imam and never do anything which distract your attention. This is in the other hadith. The Prophet ﷺ said, "Man massa al-hasa faqad lagha." even the person who play with the puppets. You know, at the time of the Prophet ﷺ, the masjid of the Messenger of Allah in Medina, it wasn't like these days. It was, there's carpet. No. There's small stones called hasa. Hasa, the very small stones, puppets. So some people, maybe they take this and they play with it. They put it in their hand. They try to clean it. So the Prophet ﷺ said, even the one who touched this stone, small stones, فَقَدْ لَغَى. That's mean he did something that nullify his Jum'ah. Why? So he concentrate. Same thing, like this day, if a person, he go and he use, you know, his miswak. You say the miswak is good, yes, but it's not the time for it. Now you should concentrate on the khutbah. Or some people, they playing with their mobile, or they play with anything else, some subha. All this will nullify their Jum'ah. Why? Because they should concentrate to understand the khutbah. Now the question is, how about the person when you advise us, what should you do? Because the hadith said, if you say to somebody, listen, stop talking, even though you are advising, you yourself, you lost your Friday. You don't get the reward of Friday. So what should you do? That means, don't talk to him. Maybe you give him, look at him, okay? Maybe make signal to him, but don't speak one word. Now, this to show you the meaning of this hadith. But there is some exception. What are these exceptions? The exception, if the Imam spoke to somebody, then it's okay for that person to speak to the Imam. Like, for example, one time the Prophet ﷺ was giving the khutbah and one man entered the masjid and seemed that he sat without praying. So the Prophet ﷺ asked him and said, did you pray? He said, no. He said, okay, قم فصلي ركعتين. Then stand up and pray two rak'ah and make it very quick. So this is to show you that it is okay for the Imam to speak to anyone. And also it is allowed to this person to respond to the Imam. Also, if a person, he wants to speak to the Imam for something which is necessary, which is important. Like one time the Prophet ﷺ was giving the khutbah, and there's one man, he entered the masjid, and he went to the messenger of Allah ﷺ while he was giving the khutbah, and he said to him, "Halakat al-amwalu wa inqata'at al-subul, fad'u Allah yughithuna." We got destruction, O Prophet of Allah. All the ways were blocked because of rain. So ask Allah Azza wa Jal to protect us. So in this case, it's okay. Also, if the Imam, while he was giving khutbah, he made mistake in one ayah, it's okay also to answer him. Now the question, how about if somebody come beside you and say to you, Assalamu alaikum, and the Imam is giving khutbah. And we know that saying salam is sunnah, but answering the salam is wajib, must. What should you do now? Should you answer him? Then that's when you spoke up and then your khutbah is not valid. In this case, don't answer him. Don't answer him. Don't say wa alaykum as-salam. And he should not say as-salam in this time. Because he knew that no one should answer him when he says as-salam. But if you feel that this person, you know, he will maybe upset if you didn't answer him salam, it's okay to say like this, you know, just, you know, greeting him with your hand, it's okay. How about if somebody sneezed? Achoo, sneezed. Is it okay for him to say Alhamdulillah? Is it okay for somebody who hear him say Yarhamukallah? And then he will respond to him again. And he will say Yahdikum Allah wa yaslih balakum. Now it's a long discussion here. No. At this time, if you sneeze and the Imam is giving khutbah, say Alhamdulillah, but quietly. Otherwise, maybe some people, ignorant people, they don't know the rule, they will say to you, Yarhamukallah. So it's better to say it quietly. And if you hear somebody say Alhamdulillah also, don't say to him, Yarhamukallah. Don't respond here. Why? Because if he spoke, then your jum'ah is not valid. Na'am. How about if the Imam during the khutbah mentioned the name of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? And we know that we were advised that whenever we heard any mentioning of the name of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam or about him as a prophet or as a messenger, we should sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we should say sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If he was mentioned, should we say sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? We can say it quietly, but not to speak. Naam? And the same thing, if the Imam make dua, it's okay to make ta'meen, but also quietly. Quietly, that's mean secretly. Not let anybody hear you. The same thing when he make dua, it's okay to say ameen, but quietly also. And because the Imam is not making dua for himself, he make dua for himself and for everyone here. This is why we said, Allahumma ahdina fi man hadayt. Okay? Oh Allah, forgive us. Oh Allah, give us help, support, protect us. Us, talking about himself and those in the masjid. If the Imam say, oh Allah, forgive me about himself, this for him, and that's not right. Alaykum as-salam wa rahmatullahi alayhi. So, here we said the Imam, it mentioned in the hadith that if the Imam say or make dua only for himself, that means he betrayed the ma'mumin, those who are praying with him. And this is when he say it loudly in the khutbah. But if he say it secretly, this is like in salah, this is between him and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, we learn from this hadith the importance of listening carefully to salat, to the khutbah of the Imam. And you see, it's enough for us to know this, how important is it, to the point that Prophet ﷺ described those people who they don't listen to the Imam like a stupid donkey that doesn't benefit from the book that it's carrying. Also, we learned that it is not lawful to say salam when the Imam is. It's not right to say salam. It's not right to say yarhamukallah for the one who's sneezing. And all this, it will distract people at the time of Salatul Jumu'ah. Should not play with anything, that you turn your attention away from the khutbah. I think we mentioned most of the point here. And then inshallah we'll continue next week. We already finished about 40 minutes, so we'll leave inshallah some time for your questions and your comments. Barakallahu feekum wa nasallahu azza wa jalla fa'ana bima naqul wa nafa'. Na'am. Do you have any questions?
Assalamu alaikum, Sheikh.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
When the Imam makes a dua, is it okay for the Ma'mumin to raise the hands and say, I mean, quietly say, or shouldn't raise the hands?
No. When the Imam, during the Jum'ah, make dua, you say, Ameen, quietly without raising your hand, except in one situation. If the Imam raised his hand when he pray, calling Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to send down rain, this is called istighatha. إذا استغاث الإمام when he said اللهم أغثنا Allahumma aghithna. You're talking, oh Allah, send down rain to us. Help us with rain. And he raised his hand, then the ma'amum raised his hand. When he finished and he returned to a normal dua, he should not raise his hand. Now.
Jazakumullah khair,
Sheikh. Now. Any other questions? No questions, brother? MashaAllah, everything is clear?
As-salamu alaykum, Sheikh.
Tafadhal ya Sa'id, hayyakallah. Alaykum as-salam wa rahmatullah.
How are you?
Alhamdulillah,
Rabbil Alameen. I just wanted to ask one question. So, is it a sunnah to say salat and salam upon Rasul after the khutbah? So, after the khutbah, along with the dua, the Imam says, Allahumma salli ala Muhammad, and so on. So,
yes.
Should we be repeating it or just saying
Ameen? Yes, as we said, you know, because the Imam at the end of the khutbah when he sent Salah and Salam on the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, then he will it's okay to say a Salah, but as we said, this quietly. This is almost at the end of the khutbah. If the Imam mentioned the name of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, then it's okay to say it quietly, secretly. Naam. طيب يا سعيد
جزاك الله خير
وهيك and other questions بارك الله فيكم طيب brothers جزاكم الله خير so إن شاء الله we'll see you next week what time is it will be next week I think it's 7:15 it will be stay also for brothers and sisters who are following us on Facebook. Please note that our class will start at 7:15. Here's a question at the Facebook from Ali. He said, if the Imam is on the khutbah when you arrive late on the Jum'ah, when then what should do? Make the two rak'ah or not? Yes, we mentioned this, and inshallah, it will come in next hadith. But here also, just to remind Ali and to everyone, if you came late, for example, and the Imam was giving the khutbah, then you should not stay till you offer two rak'ah and make it very quick. If quick, not in a quick in a way that it is not, you know, complete or perfect. Make it perfect, complete. But very light, not to make it very long and recite long verses. Before you sit, you're supposed to pray these two rak'ah. Also, there's another point, which is, unfortunately, some people are, they don't realize. Sometimes some people, they come while the mu'adhin, the one who called for the salah, is saying, the adhan, because the imam, he came already and he said, greeted the people, say assalamu alaikum, and he said for the adhan to be finished. So the muadhin is giving adhan. And you enter the masjid while the muadhin is giving adhan. What should you do? You should go ahead and pray, start your prayer, so you can finish these two rak'ah before the imam start his khutbah. Don't wait till the muadhin, the one who called him for the salah, is finish his adhan. This is wrong because listening to the adhan and repeating after the adhan, this is sunnah. But listening to the khutbah is wajib, must. Therefore, it's better when you attend or enter the masjid and the imam is going on to go ahead and don't wait till the adhan finish and play the two rak'ah so you can sit and you can listen to the khutbah. I hope this answers your question, Brother Ali. Barakallahu feek. Now, okay, so if there's no question, I think it's already time for the Salah. So inshallah, I'll see you next week. As we said, if you have any questions, you can post it in the group or you can post it in the comment area at the Facebook. Jazakumullah khair. May Allah Azza wa Jal increase us all in knowledge. Wa akhir da'wan. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Wa sallallahu sallam wa barak ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Wa alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Wa alaikum as-salam.